Okay, the next topic in the power screw is the collar friction torque. Now this is the figure for the collar friction. This is the square thread for the screw jack and these are the collar load, and here the load is acting on it. Here the DI is the inner diameter of the screw and DO is the outer diameter of this collar. This is the inner diameter of collar and this is the outer diameter of collar. Just remember this part. Okay, so the collar is used to avoid the sliding force. It should not go directly. To hold the load also it is used here, collar. So the cup remains stationary under the action of load here. So the collar that is integral with the screw rotates when the load is being raised or lower. Only when we raise or lower the load, at that time only it will move. So this total depend on the DI and DO. So the relative motion result in friction called the collar friction. Okay, due to this it is the collar friction. You can just remember the definition also. So the torque required to overcome this friction or collar friction is MTC, that is the torque for collar, can be determined with the help of uniform pressure theory and uniform wear theory, which we have learned in the unit number 1. Okay, so the uniform pressure theory, torque is what? Direct equation is given to us, mu Cw upon 3 into DO cube minus DI cube, divided by DO square minus DI square. So we get the collar friction here. Okay, not the collar friction, actually it is the torque equation for collar using uniform pressure theory. Now using wear theory will explain in this way, that is mu Cw by 4 into DO minus DO plus DI. So this equation is helpful for calculating the torque based on uniform pressure theory and uniform wear theory. But when to use uniform wear theory and when to use uniform pressure theory, that we must know. First we will understand that what is mu C. Mu C is the coefficient of friction at the collar, DO is the outer diameter of the collar, DI is the inner diameter of the collar, and MT. So now uniform pressure theory is only applicable when the collar surface is new, and uniform wear theory is applicable when the collar surface is wear out or it is becoming old. So pressure theory is not applicable most of the time. It is mostly logical to use uniform wear theory because it gives a proper dimension for collar diameters. So in certain applications the torque between the curb and the screw is replaced by thrust ball bearing to reduce the friction. Now what this thrust ball bearing help us? It reduces the sliding friction, or you can say they replace the sliding friction by the rolling friction. So the collar friction torque becomes almost negligible in this case. So the equation, that is according to the uniform pressure theory, is this mu Cw by 3, and uniform wear theory is this. So this is the final equation which you get here. Okay. So this equation should not be used where rolling contact bearings are employed to take the thrust reaction. Okay. Thank you.